making a fighter's entrance on the long, hard road to victory.
Tonight, Queenslanders voted for change. Tonight, Queenslanders voted for David Crisafulli.
A fist pump to power. David Crisafulli waves in a new era after winning over Queenslanders, with the crowd in a frenzy.
Tonight, Queenslanders have voted for hope over fear. They have voted for a fresh start, and they have voted for a majority LNP government.
Vindicated.
The biggest achievement we've had in over a decade. Tonight was the turning corner of the youth crime crisis.
Ingham, born and bred, the grandson of Italian immigrants, thanked those who voted for the Liberal National Party for the first time in a long time, borrowing the famous words from late Labor giant Gough Whitlam.
It's time.
Yes, it is.
It's time for a fresh start for Queensland.
It was a rollercoaster evening while waiting for pre-poll votes to be counted, but then the end of Labor's decade-long reign became clear.
I gave this election everything I had.
Still, Stephen Miles stopped short of congratulating his opponent.
It is clear that that hasn't been enough to secure a majority of seats for Labor, and also that the LNP is unlikely to have a majority.
But more Labor seats started turning blue.
Now we're going to go back to Riles at the screen with the biggest projection, 7 News projection so far of the night. Riles?
Yep, there have been many projections, but this is the big one. We are now projecting that the Liberal National Party, the LNP, will form majority government in Queensland.
Russell Field beating Don Brown in Capalaba.
I'm standing up for all victims, past, present and future.
The LNP heading for majority government with at least 49 seats in the Legislative Assembly. Labor downsized to 30. The cat is 3, 1 Green and 1 Independent. Robbie Katter holding firm on his abortion stance.
That's called democracy. We are allowed to express an alternate view. And, you know, you seem to conveniently never mention there's babies in this equation.
Not even 12 hours after becoming the Premier-elect...
Thanks very much, guys. We'll see you tomorrow.
..power walking to Parliament.
We're underway.
In a merry mood.
We're not going to Christmas with the same set of laws.
Running on adrenaline and barely any sleep.
2:30 to about 4:45.
Meeting with the state's top public servants bright and early.
I had a phone call this morning with the current Director-General of Premier and Cabinet, Mr Mike Kaiser. He was incredibly gracious in that phone call. The Public Sector Commissioner David Mackey will be the Acting Director General of the Premier's Department.
The shredding truck's moving in to 1 William Street.
But before he can really get to work, the Premier-elect will need to make the historic trip to Government House.
45-year-old David Frank Crisafulli set to be sworn in as the 41st Premier of Queensland.
Well, David Crisafulli met with the governor late this afternoon, receiving a mandate to govern the state. He'll be sworn in as premier tomorrow morning. Jared Blay will be sworn in as deputy premier, and they'll take responsibility of the new ministry before a new cabinet is decided on. There'll be MPs jostling for positions in that new cabinet so they can start work on their 100-day plan. The focus will be on new laws dealing with young criminals. The Premier-elect has also had a phone call with the Prime Minister. They spoke about the Olympics and funding for the Bruce Highway. As a former minister in the one-term Newman government, David Crisafulli knows how demoralising it is to lose power. And now that the Crisafulli comeback is complete, he doesn't want to be a one-term Premier. He's told his team to saddle up for the long haul. Less than 24 hours after claiming victory, he's already thinking about his legacy.
Elena, well, at State Parliament, thank you.